is not an easy trek. Okay. So I'm going along here and I'm coming across some sign. There's none right around. There's human sign. That's from my last trip down here. I stopped over there just at the end of that rise over there. So you can see my progress. Yeah. I had to take a minute. Take a breather, take a look at these, really. This is not an easy trek. Okay, look at the nice rocks over there. Guardian mountainy stuff. So I'm going along here and I'm coming across some sign. There's none right around. There's human sign. That's from my last trip down here. I stopped over there, just at the end of that rise over there. So you can see my progress. Yeah. I had to take a minute, take a breather, take a look at these really tall, beautiful trees. It's beautiful. Send it sideways, take a picture. Just recorded stuff as I go. I don't know if I'll run out or what, but we'll see. I came down this road here. Came over here. Chopped out a section so I could get through with my sled thing. Went through here. I showed you this before. It was all packed down. It's not so packed anymore. Got my fire going. Just started. It's going good, cheerily. So as you see, there's a lot of dead stuff. I'm gonna take these standing dead ones down, some of them, and cut them up. There's a lot of dead stuff just laying on the ground here that I can use. There's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 fallen trees, 9 trees that I could take down. So here's how I got it set up. I got a stick there holding the tarp up over me. I got my bivy here. I got some snackies. There's a bucket here. That's a bucket. Alright, so set myself up a tripod, cheapo tripod. Dry off my gloves. See, I'm making some pea soup. I made a little pot. On a berm, I dug it down. Okay, I dug down in there, like this. Okay, and all around where the fire is. Right? And then I put the tarp in like that and folded it down. I've got some snow anchors in here, you can't see them. Then, I put sticks in, like this. And piled snow up. That way, and along here, that's all happening because of the, then this is my stick that's poking it up there, it's covered up, anyway, more, see, you can see the debris, I've covered it up, it's really, it's worked pretty good, all basalt, yeah. As you can see, it's very dark out. You can't see me or anything. You can see the fire here. Hey there, you can see me, I think. Hope you can see me. Well, it's dark out. It's very dark. I got my coffee here, my tea, I mean. Beautiful fire. Little update, it's about 6:30, 7 o'clock p.m. Very dark out, as you can see. Okay. So, here's my supper today. Pork, pork chop. There's a can of soup there. I've been boiling all kinds of water and stuff in there, so that's gonna be a nice little, I don't know, boiling some water, or melting some water, shall I say. Got this going on, my tea. Okay, so here's my supper. Just cut a piece here. Take a look. See how it's cooked here. Not too bad. Not too bad. Awesome. I'm gonna eat that for sure. Hunger, hunger. Enjoy. I'm getting warm by the fire and drying myself off. Okay, have a good night. It's 9:30. Good morning. One, two, I guess it's about 8. Somewhere between 8 and 9 in the morning this morning. Beautiful day. Watching the sun come up in the trees. I fixed my tripod. It was all messed up. And you can see here, went all right. I was cold last night though, a little bit. Ran out of wood, or almost ran out of wood. The fire died down and pretty much died. I had to get out of bed and build the fire up. That was about 2 o'clock this morning. There was only like one little log and just a very tiny amount of coals left. Ooh, I heard a bird. Heard a woodpecker earlier today. That was awesome. Sang the song for the morning song. Yeah. Anyway, so I was gonna build a fire reflector here, right there, right here actually, right beside the fire. The fire was here, and I tried to pound in that first stick there, over there, but the ground was frozen. So what I'm doing is I've moved the fire over, and then when it's thawed out, I'll move the fire back and I'll pound the stakes in there. That way they'll hold and they'll go like I'm thawing the ground out basically. So that's what I'm doing. Need a wide fire for the night because it's freaking cold, man. Negative 20 degrees. I was shivering. Brr, brr, brr. But look here, I see mouse tracks. I think it's a mouse. I don't know what it is. Look. It came out of here. Now this little hole here down here. Hi, buddy. I hope I'm not bugging you. And he ran along. Actually, he went in this hole from what I could tell by the tail. Look at this. You see this? Anybody know what tracks these are? It's like a tail. So I'm thinking a mouse. What do you think? Let me know. All right. Ooh, there's a big tree I can take right there. Bing, bang, boom. But as you see, I did my firewall, or my fire reflector. So what this will do is it will reflect the heat to me, make it warmer. I feel the warmth from here. I'm not even very far away. I'm pretty far away. Well, about 5, maybe 10 feet away. No, 5 feet, 4 feet away from the actual fire. And I feel the heat, so it's working. That's good, because apparently last night was negative 30 Celsius. That's really cold, just so you know. Yeah, that's like, I think it's around negative 10 to 15 Fahrenheit. I'm not sure. Anyway, it's Thursday evening. I don't remember what time it is. The sun just set, or it is setting, so I'd say it's probably somewhere around, 6:30, somewhere around there. And we'll see when I'm done. Anyway, however, but take it easy. Bye. Morning or good evening. It's like 5:30, 6 o'clock. I got a gift of chocolate milk, so I'm cheating and I'm making some hot chocolate. It's taking a sweet time to heat up, but it's okay.
Good morning. It's Friday.
It's about 2 o'clock in the morning.
1:45. I had to get up, fix the fire. Looks okay now. I also noticed that my boots are very wet, or not wet, but frozen. I'll let them sit like that for a little while. You can't see them, but anyway.
Hey. I know. You can't see me. That's okay. Well, it's about 6 o'clock, 6:30 in the morning. The moon's up there somewhere. Can't see it. Here's the fire. You can't see anything. There's no light. Anyway, it's Friday morning. I'm heading out. At 2 o'clock this afternoon, I'm heading out of the bush, so once the sun comes up over there, which you can't see, then I will begin to pack up my stuff. Most of it, at least. I'll keep my breakfast stuff out and my coffee stuff out. That stuff will get packed last. Check this out. We got, I don't know if you'll be able to see, all of the branches above my fire are all filled with rime, which is like basically frost. You see it all? Isn't that beautiful? Look at that. That's all. And it's all only over my fire. Coming from the wood. That's so freaking cool. 6 degrees close up. Whoa. I'm almost done here. I got a couple of hours left. I think it's about 7. It's daylight now, so it's about 7 o'clock. Sun's coming up over there. Yeah. When the sun reaches right here, time to get back. But these are really big, thick, solid, cold, frozen chunks. I got about 12 pieces out of that, all chopped by axe. One heck of a freaking workout, I tell you, man. Work. Stripped down to like just my hoodie in negative 20, which is cold. It's like plus 5 or Fahrenheit or 0 Fahrenheit. Anyway, well, not, yeah. Anyway, strip down and then stop and have to get dressed right away. Otherwise, you freeze. You get hypothermia. I'm doing pretty good though. Feeling good. And ready to go home and take a freaking bath, man, I tell you. I'm dirty as all that. Very dirty. My hands are black. My face is probably black. I don't know. I can't see them. My white boots are no longer white. And you see, here's the snow, and that's what colors they were, approximately. So my boots aren't white anymore. That's what happens when I do fire keeping with my big boots on. My big boy moose boots. That's what they're called. That's what I call them. Worked really well. I brought it right here. It was like right here where the chair is. I put it right here. Had one or two sparks, but it was all right. And my saw sucks really badly. Okay, it's, I don't know, 7:30, maybe? Look, my nose is all cracked from the smoke. It hurts. Some char cloth. You see here? This is an old Zippo container. And I bought my, I think this is from my, one of my ex-girlfriends gave me this, I think. What's going on? I don't know how to use this. Oh, crap. Okay. All right. So, let's see. It looks done. Pure cotton cloth. And basically what I did was I baked it. No oxygen. So I'm gonna try it out. So give me a second here. I'm just gonna get my sparking tool. My sparker. I'll show you how it works. Alrighty. Here we go. Okay. Alright, so. Give it a bit of spark. So you see the way it's glowing? It takes a spark and it glows like that. So you can take it and blow on it. Whoops. Put some tinder in it. Oh! Put some tinder in that and it'll. That's it, man. Pretty cool, huh? Works good. Maybe not be much, but it'll, you could start something from that. Pretty cool, huh? So I'll save that for later. My new char cloth container that I'm gonna make char cloth with from now on. So right now I'm just getting some more water going. That blue water bottle froze solid last night. I didn't put it in my tote like I normally do. I keep a bottle tied around my neck, hanging around my neck, and it's in my coat, inside my layers. So in the winter, thirsty, I can drink some normal temperature water, but also like it's not super cold. And then I just take the bottom off and I fill it up with snow,
reattach it and put it back in my shirt. My heat, my body heat, especially when I'm working, melts the snow, so I always have water with me, fresh water. It doesn't have minerals and all that because it's snow and ice, but
here's my setup.
Yeah,
I don't have a sled, so I use my tarp. Check it out. Really? Oh. I got a bobo in my finger somewhere. A lot of bobos. My knuckle's swollen too, I'm not sure why. Anyway, I think I might have an infection in my hand. Oh, see? Not bad. Just like Mama used to do it. Here's where the tarp used to be, the tent there that I was. Right there. You can see I've... That's a shelf here. Here's my walls, sticks, and the shelf where I put the log and everything to hold it down. More sticks. Here's the fire. That was my coffee station and my food prep area. That's where I burned things. There's my tripod there. I'm leaving it. I'm leaving the fire reflector also, because I'll be here again. I'm coming back. That's where my wood was, it's all gone. That's the last bit there. So, that's good. Had a good little workout, had a good time. Yeah. Did you know that you can be really cold and shivering and still sleep? So I found out yesterday, went down to minus 30, and that's 0 degrees Fahrenheit. Last night, it wasn't as cold, probably about negative 20, which is about 10 or 15 Fahrenheit. Anyway, I had a good time. Hope you all enjoy all these videos. There's like 100,000 of them. I'm gonna have fun putting them in order. I'm gonna try and put them into one video. So if you're watching one video, cool. If you're not, have fun, and I'm glad you made it to the end. Have a great life day. Have a great Facebook. Have a great YouTube or whatever you're doing over there, out there, out and about. Boot in a boot. Can you tell I'm Canadian, eh? All right. Tuksha, hey. I'll see you all later. Okay. So, I'm all set up, got my coffee, I'm waiting for my ride. I made a coffee with the propane stove in there. That's my last little coffee. Got my chair, my smoke, and my coffee packed up. It's Friday noon. My brother came and visited me here. He was driving a four-wheeler, but with tracks. It's pretty cool. Well, that's all right. Anyway, so I'm waiting for my ride, and you have a great day. It's 2 o'clock Friday afternoon.